يا أيها الذين آمنوا اصبروا وصابروا ورابطوا واتقوا الله لعلكم تفلحون.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، نحمد الله ونصلي على رسوله الكريم، ما بعد. In today's recitation, Alhamdulillah, the Qurra recited Surah Al-Muminun and also completed the recitation of Surah Al-Nur. And they started the recitation of Surah Al-Furqan. Today in my discussion, I will discuss a few verses from Surah Al-Mu'minun. And I'm hoping that inshallah, Sheikh Abdullah and Mufti Abdul Rahman in tonight's session, they will talk about the stories and the lessons from Surah Al-Nur, because there are beautiful lessons in that surah, which I will not be able to cover in the limited time that I have today. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins Surah Al-Mu'minun speaking about, or rather, making declaring a statement, and making a statement that is ends with a period, and there is absolutely no question about this statement. There's no doubt about this statement, and that statement is قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ, that verily, the believing men and women are successful. This is it. There's no what if and okay. And then what happens then? Or are you sure? There's no ifs and buts. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ, that the believing men and women are certainly successful. And أَفْلَحَ in the Arabic language is used for a farmer. فَلَّاح is a farmer. So the reason why it's used for success is because when a farmer plants his seeds and he waters the seeds for the entire year, and finally when the time comes to harvest the seeds, and he's able to see the blessing of the crops or the seeds that he brought out, that is a successful person. He feels successful. He feels as if he has achieved something because he worked on that the entire year. So Allah is saying that أَفْأَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ, that this word of falah is different than najaha. Najaha also means success. But falaha is success in the akhirah, that in this life we're planting our seeds, planting our seeds of a'mal, planting our seeds of adhkar. And the moment we get to the akhirah, it's time for harvest. It's time to see the reward that we planted, the seeds that we planted. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with the reward of the akhirah. But who are these believers? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives five descriptions of these believers. Number one, أَلَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ, that there are people who have khushu', who have humility, who have God consciousness in their prayer. They're not just praying passively like the munafiqun. وَإِذَا قَامُوا إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ قَامُوا كُسَالًا وَلَا يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا, they would stand in a manner of being lazy. They would stand without remembering Allah except for a little bit. Allah says these are people in their prayer that have khushu'. People always ask, how can I earn khushu'? One of the tips to earn khushu' is to take care of our khudu', meaning, in order to earn internal connection to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our external limbs and our acts should be in accordance to the orders of Allah. I.e. that the way we're supposed to perform ruku' with slowly, with serenity, with peace, that ruku' should not be performed fast. The way sajda should be performed slowly, with reading my subhanallah clearly and slowly to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's how sajda should be performed, without praying in a rush. The Prophet says that, do you know who the worst robber is, the worst stealer? And the Sahaba said, who is the worst stealer? And the Prophet responded by saying, the one who steals from his prayer. And the Sahaba asked, how can one steal from their prayer? And the Prophet responded by saying that they perform the sajda in ruku' without completing it. Khashi'un is internal connection to Allah. But that happens because our external actions are being done in accordance with our sunnah. Number two, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُعْرِضُونَ, that there are individuals who turn away from obscene talk, who turn away from futile talk, who turn away from talk which has absolutely no benefit, neither in this world nor the akhirah. So it has no benefit. If it has some benefit, they may engage in it. But if it has no benefit, they'll turn away. That is a sign of a believer, right? وَعِبَادُ الرَّحْمَنِ الَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنًا وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا, that the slaves of Allah are those that walk on the earth with humility, and when they're challenged with something that cannot benefit them, they move away. They don't engage in a conversation which cannot fruit any benefit, which cannot bring any benefit. So number two, there are people who would walk away from a conversation which does not give them benefit. In our time, we speak for the sake of speaking. We speak for the sake of being heard. We don't speak because we need to speak. We speak because we want to be heard. Allah is saying, hey, you know, just walk away, move away. Don't engage in that conversation. Don't sit in a place where people are backbiting. Don't sit in a place where people are being vulgar in their speech. Rather, move away. Number three, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِلزَّكَاةِ فَاعِلُونَ. There are people who complete, they're giving their zakat. They don't hold back their zakat. Right? And one of the quickest ways to earn barakah in our wealth is to make sure we're giving our zakat. And similarly, one of the quickest ways to lose a barakah in our wealth is to hold back our zakat. Zakat is not money that we own. That percentage belongs to Allah. Therefore, whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about giving zakat, He always says, وَمِمَّا رَزَقَنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. That they are spending from the money that we gave them. It's ours. Right? You're just giving it back to us. It removes the filth in our wealth. Literally, the word zakka yuzakki means to purify. So when we give our zakat, we are purifying our wealth. It's like that dirty oil in the car that when you put in a new oil change, when you have an oil change, you flush out the oil. Flushing out the oil is important. You can't mix the new oil with the old oil. Similarly, flushing out the filth of our wealth is our zakat. Even if there's something wrong with that wealth, or you know, we had some filth in it, by giving our zakat, we hope that Allah purifies it. Number five. So number one is they have khushu in their salat. Number two is that they stay away from any form of lahu, obscene talk. Number three, they give their zakat. Number four, they protect their modesty. They only spend time with the people that they're allowed to have a relationship with, i.e. their spouses. They don't go out and transgress the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in their modesty. Now this doesn't only mean in a major sin, no, modesty in their eyes, modesty in their ears, modesty in their tongue, that they protect their modesty. The Prophet told us, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِذَا فَقَدْتُمُ الْحَيَا فَاصْنَعُوا مَا شِئْتُمْ. If you lose the quality of haya, you can do whatever you want because nothing will stop you now. So having haya in our life is a quality of a believer. And number five, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِأَمَانَاتِهِمْ وَأَحَدِهِمْ رَاعُونَ. There are people, this is very important, there are people who uphold their promises and their covenants with others. They hold their amana. Their tongue is worth something. When they say something, it actually means that it has weight behind it. Not that it's just fluff that's coming out of their mouth or our mouth. There are people who uphold their covenants, uphold their promises. One of the first signs of the Day of Judgment is amana will be lost from the people. People will not find others to trust. And they'll have to travel a long distance or a far distance to find someone they can trust. A sign of a believer is that they are people who can be trusted by others. And they can hold the trust. Not the munafiqun. The munafiqun, their sign is, وَيَأْتُ مِنَ أَخَانَا. When someone trusts them with something, they don't know how to hold it. They'll break that trust. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَوْفُوا بِالْعُقُودِ. Allah says that in Surah Ma'idah, that fulfill your covenants and fulfill your promises. If it's with your spouse, if you said there was a mahar, fulfill that promise. If it's with your children, fulfill that promise. If it's with a co-worker, don't go back on your word. This is a sign of a believer. And lastly, Allah says five signs. And at the end of this, Allah says once again, it all starts from praying salat. If you're praying salat, these things will also fall into place. And then Allah says, what is the reward for these people? What is their success? What is their harvest that they will receive? أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْوَارِثُونَ الَّذِينَ يَرِثُونَ الْفِرْدَوْسِ. That these people will be individuals who will inherit Jannah. وَرَثَ يَرِثُ. They will inherit. Allah doesn't say they will give them Jannah. They will inherit Jannah. Because inheritance is the most pure form of wealth. Because there's no way it can be taken away from you. Right? You earned it. There's no way your father's wealth does not come to you. Unless it's you're stripped of your right from someone else. Similarly, وَرَثَ يَرِثُ means Allah says there's no way this Jannah will not come to you. It's a given. You'll have it for sure. It's just a matter of time now. Just like inheritance, it's a matter of time when someone passes away. May Allah protect us and our families. Similarly, Jannah is that reward that is there for us. It's just a matter of time when we leave this world that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless us with that Jannah. May Allah bless you all for joining. Jazakallahu khair once again. And I truly am grateful to all of you for being a part of our programs. Lastly, we do have a program taking place right now at 3 p.m. It's a webinar. Inshallah, we have a beautiful nasheed artist joining us. We have scholars from all across the country, Imam Khalid Latif, Ubaidullah Evans, Sheikh Abdullah, Mufti Abdul Rahman. I will also be there. Please tune in, go from here to there and tune in. And inshallah, I'm sure you will all benefit. Jazakallah khair. Subhanallah, bihamdi, subhanakallahu bihamdik. سبحان ربك رب العزة ما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين الحمد لله رب العالمين. Hope to see you all there. I'm gonna jump on the webinar right now. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.